today's video in a nutshell. If you're a fanboy of Intel, do tell. Oh well, one of your kidneys you must sell. Is it worth it? Only time will tell. If you like this, hit the notification bell. Allow this writer write so many words for what?
Jokes aside, we know that there's still a lot of you Intel hardcore fans out there that has been waiting patiently for the new 10th gen processors to drop, as well as the Z490 chipset. Today, we're gonna build the most extreme, extra, expensive Intel PC to help you experience the best that Intel has to offer right now. And also, we're gonna answer a few questions, such as, number one, what are the upgrades that you can look forward to? Number two, what are the recommended components that you should pick to pair with this beefy i9 processor, as well as the new Z490 motherboards? Number three, how much does clock speed really matter, and should you even attempt a manual overclock? Number four, does RAM speed matter, and is it worth it to splurge on expensive RAM? Turn, here's the 10th gen Core i9-10900K processor, as well as the reviewer's package that's pretty much the same as the one that Hardware Canucks received. Look, Ma, I've made it. Anyways, because of competition, which is a very beautiful thing, Intel is now trying to cater to more consumers' needs by pushing out an i9 that is not only a single-threaded gaming machine, but also offers pretty competitive multi-threaded performance for workstation tasks. Which is very good news considering that we are all battling the pandemic crisis right now and most of us has to work from home. Compared to its predecessor, this new 10th gen i9 now has 2 more cores at 10 cores and 20 threads, as well as improved clock speeds. Now, Intel achieved this by making structural changes to the CPU itself, by thickening the IHS, as well as making the die thinner to increase thermal efficiency. With these new processors, we are also introduced with a brand new Z490 chipset, which runs on a new LGA 1200 socket. The extra pins enable PCIe Gen 4 support, which is only coming with future generations, so no luck for 10th gen here. Also, Intel is pushing out 2.5 gigabit Ethernet as well as Wi-Fi 6 as the new standard. That's pretty awesome. So here's the flagship from Aorus, the Z490 Aorus Xtreme motherboard. And with this new motherboard, they've made a few improvements, such as including a 10 gigabit Ethernet, an additional Thunderbolt 3 port, as well as a 16-phase digital VRM solution to provide a better and more stable power delivery. Very, very extremely expensive also lah. So without further ado, let's build this thing. Let's get cracking. For the processor, we have the i9-10900K with 10 cores and 20 threads, a 3.7 GHz base clock and 5.3 GHz boost clock. For the motherboard, we have the Z490 Aorus Xtreme. It has an EATX form factor, so make sure that you pick a chassis that would fit it. It is very sleek and black with gunmetal accents and also RGB fusion support. Very nice. For the RAM, we're using the Aorus RGB memory that comes with two sticks of 8GB DDR4 rated at 600MHz and two dummy sticks with RGB enabled, because more RGB is always better. For storage, we're using two separate Aorus M.2 NVMe PCIe SSDs. One of them is a 500GB Gen 3 SSD and the other one is a 512GB Gen 4 SSD. We're gonna be using the Gen 4 for OS and applications, while the Gen 3 will be used for games and media files for video editing. You can only take advantage of the full Gen 4 speeds once the next generation of CPUs come out. So, for the case, we have the Aorus C300 mid-tower ATX chassis with a tempered glass side panel, comes with two fans and an RGB Aorus logo at the front. For the cooler, we chose a beefier Aorus Liquid Cooler 360, which is a 360ml all-in-one liquid cooler, and the water block and pump even has a display that shows the temperature and all the other good stuff, so it's easier to monitor while you're overclocking. For the graphics card, we have the Aorus Xtreme RTX 2080 Ti, the king of GPUs right now to pair with the most powerful offering from Intel, so we can get the best possible performance without bottlenecking. We have the power supply, which is the Aorus P850W. Modular 80 plus gold power supply. We recommend that you go for a quality 750 watts power supply and above, because you're gonna need a little bit more headroom when overclocking this beast of a processor. Finally, We're pairing this PC with the F127Q Tactical Gaming Monitor from Aorus, which is a 1440p IPS panel with a refresh rate of 165Hz and 1ms MPRT response time. They say that this is rated at 95% DCI P3, but we haven't tested it yet, so maybe you should wait for our next video. Hint hint. Here are the individual prices for all the components if you are interested. We're gonna be doing some Cinebench, Shadow of Tomb Raider, CSGO, and Premiere Pro.
Moving on!
First up, we have synthetic benchmarks starting with Cinebench, and as expected, higher clock speeds resulted in higher scores, especially in the multi-threaded test. Single core scores didn't fluctuate a lot, probably because of turbo boost. And also, as you can see, when we turned down memory speeds, it didn't make much of a difference. Now let's look at games. And the first one is the Shadow of the Tomb Raider. As you can see, overclocking didn't seem to improve performance that much, but turning down memory speeds did negatively impact the FPS. This is probably because large AAA games constantly load data into memory, so RAM speeds will definitely impact the performance. In CSGO, as expected, higher clock speeds resulted in better performance, most probably due to the older Source engine. Turning down memory speeds did impact it a little bit, but in this case, it's almost equally as important as clock speeds. Now let's look at real-world numbers, and in Premiere Pro, we rendered one of our unboxing videos in 4K with a CBR of 100 megabits per second. Both CPU and memory frequencies noticeably affected render times. Like I've mentioned many times before, clock speed does affect performance in Premiere Pro quite a bit, and RAM capacity and speed is crucial for video editing, especially in higher resolutions. Now let's look at something that everybody is debating about. Temperatures. At stock speeds, the processor stayed at decent temperatures under load at 76 degrees. With our 5.1 GHz overclock, it went up to a whopping 91 degrees. We could have pushed it even further, but I was just getting a little bit uncomfortable with the temperature. For most use case scenarios on an everyday basis, we do recommend that you stick to stock, or you can go to an all-core 5.0 GHz overclock, if you have a beefier cooler, that is. From the numbers shown, you can see different scenarios and how clock speeds and RAM speeds matter accordingly. In titles such as The Shadow of the Tomb Raider, pushing for higher clock speeds might not matter as much, but skimping out on RAM will definitely affect your performance. In games such as CSGO, clock speeds do matter and so do RAM speeds. If you're doing heavier workloads such as rendering or 3D work, clock speeds will definitely matter to you. In a nutshell, if you're with Intel, you don't really need to try and squeeze every last drop of juice from your processor, as Intel's Turbo Boost and BIOS algorithm these days are already pretty good at scaling and boosting the frequencies according to your needs. But please do not cheap out on RAM, or you're going to suffer something called bottleneck. As you can see, we've managed to build a PC that is not only great in gaming, but also not be a slouch in multi-threaded tasks. Aorus has released a whole slew of products that will be all you'll ever need to build a PC. Although we think that you should probably upgrade the RAM if you want to use this beefy i9 processor. But then again, that new Aorus Xtreme motherboard is just... Of course, if you're not a bangsawan like me, you should probably just watch out for more builds on this platform in the future, which will encompass the newer and more affordable other chipsets and not the Z490. But if you are a bangsawan, what are you still waiting for? Huh? For money to grow on tree, for your neighbor to stop drilling, huh? They will never stop. Just like money will never grow on tree. So you should just work harder and buy it. If you thought this video is awesome, please give us a like and subscribe. If you hate my neighbor for drilling, please leave a comment and let me know if you have experienced similar situations. And I'll see you in the next one. Drill? Drill? Finish already, man? Don't drill for what now? Huh? Just now I talk, then you drill. Walao eh. Mother green ah! See? You see that? Soar to new heights and get an Aorus tumbler for free when you purchase a Z490 motherboard. It will keep your hot drinks warm so you don't lose your steam while you're gaming. Steady bomb, beep beep.